All right. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Friends, and this is Friends on Air Europe. Welcome to the program. Okay, this afternoon is our last part of our study about God's principle or God's help plan. Okay, so better yet, you have to watch first the previous video that we have yesterday in the part one, because I've given there a lot of principles that we need to understand, some basic principle wherein why God wants us to be healthy. And this afternoon, this is the more details, more details on some other items that we did take up yesterday. So I'm lucky enough to have you this afternoon, and please be with me and enjoy as we study the Bible once more. Okay, Bible principle on health, we will know from here, right here, from the Bible itself. Okay, let's move on, guys. So, but before that, let me share first my video once again. Okay, here, okay, just a couple of minutes, guys. So, okay, here, all right, okay, and there we go. More on, okay, and let's share from, okay, but this afternoon we'll have a short study, I guess, because we have started this already yesterday, so just the remaining topic that we have to underscore this afternoon. Okay, while doing this later as well, I'm going to read some names of those people who have shared and have an interaction with my watch party. Okay, I have to make this fast. All right, there you go. Okay. Okay. And more on this, more. Okay, more on these guys. Okay, here. Okay. And yeah, here. Okay. More. More names, and here, okay, and worldwide, okay, more, then, there we go, we have a lot of friends that I need to talk as well, and, okay, here, okay, here, one more chance, and here, and that would be all for this time, okay. There we go. Okay, thank you for your patience. Every time I've started my program, I need to share to the groups as well as to some people who are watching right now. Okay, as you can see right now, you can see a lot, guns of fruits here and vegetable. This is the I use this one so that you will be reminded that what is important in our lives, we need to take and intake what is God's principles, or what are the principles that have given us by God for us to be careful of what we have to intake, as well as what we have to take in our meal, or should I say the food that we eat. Okay, that's the best thing I should say. Okay, this afternoon I'm going to greet some friends here. Okay, let's go. Okay, Igba, okay, it's hard name. Igboanugo, Dominion, from Africa. Duchess Catherine, I'm not sure, Catherine, whatever you are, friend, thank you for watching. Okay, you may be from Asia or from Africa as well. Okay, James Cotley, okay, from Africa, I guess. Jean Palaya Foronda from Milan, Italy. And Ray Canua from Philippines, and Marlin Gumatas from Philippines. Okay, thank you for your time, okay, spending with me as I do our watch party. All right, guys, I have to share now our screen here so that we'll have a guide of our discussion or our Bible study. Okay, there we go, guys. Okay, can you see it now? I hope so. So here. Oh, God's help, because this is our part two. Okay. I guess. Okay. Okay, have to go down. Supposedly this is on this should be one topic, but the problem is that we cannot tackle it in one setting because it takes a long period of time, meaning it consume your time. So better yet, I have to make it in series. Now we are in God's Help Plan part 2 of 2. Okay, let's go now, guys. So what is the goal of our study or Bible study this afternoon? Is the continuation of the principles, principle in the Bible. So let's check question number one. And the Bible is ready to answer this question. Okay, why is it that I cannot see my face in here? Okay, there you go. Okay, it's late. Okay, what are some of the simple yet important health laws found in the Bible? So better yet, you have to listen carefully because I'm going to share with you 14 Bible health principles. When we say principle, these are laws, these are commands that we need to take heed. Okay, what is the first one? Let's, letter A. Blessed art thou, O land, when thy king is the son of nobles, and thy princes eat in due season for strength and not for drunkenness. What? The princes eat in due season for strength. So meaning we eat for strength, or we eat because we want to become strong and not for drunkenness. Okay, and that's clear according to Ecclesiastes 10:17. All right, it shall be a perpetual statute. When we say perpetual, would be lasting forever. For your generation throughout all your dwellings, that ye eat neither fat nor blood. So it's clear again here, fat and blood are not part of our meal should be. Okay, Leviticus chapter 3, verse 17. Okay, let's continue. Science has confirmed that most heart attacks result from cholesterol, and that the use of fats is largely responsible for high levels of cholesterol. It looks like the Lord knows what he's talking about after all, doesn't it? So it's very clear from here, guys, fat is not good for our health. It will lead to various diseases that we will suffer. Nowadays, it's not easy to get sick. Why? so very expensive. Insurance here in Switzerland is so high. So it's very expensive, Toya. So it's not easy. So you need to pay first. Here in Switzerland, here in, particularly in Switzerland, you have to pay first your expenses in the hospital when you had your checkup or examination. You have to pay first. Yeah. You have the insurance. Then afterwards, you have to send to the insurance company the bills of the hospital that you had paid already. Then you have to reimburse. So it's tiring. It takes long. Okay. Here, so that's why we need to be careful of what we eat. Okay. Here, fat and blood not allowed. Okay. Okay. Next one, next principle is, and put a knife to thy throat if thou be a man given to appetite. Okay, Proverbs 23, verse 2, and Luke 21, 34, Christ is specifically warned against surfeiting, intemperance, gluttony. Okay, in the last days, overeating, a form of intemperance, is responsible for many degenerative diseases. People nowadays are gluttonous. We eat much. Okay, we eat more than what we need. Okay, we eat so much. Like this picture, he eats many kinds of food here and here. So it is a sin as well to become a glutton. Okay, gluttonous is a sin. So here, that is intemperance, okay, overeating. Okay, principle number 3, don't harbor envy or hold grudges. These kinds of sinful feelings actually disrupt body processes. The Bible says that envy is rottenness to the bones. Proverbs 14:30, Christ even commanded us to clear off grudges that others might hold against us. So it's not only food. Okay, you get the point, friends. It's not only the food that makes us sick. It's also the way we treat other people. It's all about our emotion as well. People who are envied with other people, envy. Okay. Okay, thinking other things that don't belong to you, right? You are envy. So this also causes sickness in our body. So we should avoid this kind of attitude of being envious with other people. Okay, let's continue. Okay, next principle is maintain a cheerful, happy disposition. A merry heart doeth good like medicine. This is in Proverbs 17:22. Okay, guys and friends, you have to be happy. You have to your disposition must be in positive way. Okay, your outlook in life must be positive so that you would not be affected. Because if you are pessimistic, then your life will be in a low, okay, you will be sad as well. So therefore, we need to be cheerful enough. Okay, you should know how to smile, how to be happy deep in your side. Okay, because there is a difference between happiness and joy. Happiness, sometimes it depends on the situation. It based on circumstances. Like for instance, if you have a girlfriend, then you are happy. When you broke up, then you are sad. That's happiness. But if we talk about joy, it is the gift of God through the Holy Spirit. Yeah, joy is a gift of God. Okay, fruit of the Holy Spirit. So you must have this joy for the rest of your lives, not by circumstance, but because you are a happy person. You have joy. Okay, let's read from Proverbs 23, verse 7. It says here, for as he thinketh in his heart, so is he. Okay, many diseases from which people suffer a result of depression. Okay, you cannot argue with this, me. This is true. There is truth on this. Depression, especially United States. Okay, a lot of percentage of people in the United States are depressed or they are attacked by depression. Why? Because of the lifestyle that they have. Same with here in Europe. Life here is not easy. You have to work. Sometimes you forgot to take rest. Okay, so depression, why? Because you have a lot of worries in life. Okay, a cheerful, happy disposition imparts health and prolongs life. Okay, next principle, put full trust in the Lord. The fear of the Lord tendeth to life, and he that hath it shall abide satisfied. He shall not be visited with evil. Proverbs 19:23 and Proverbs 4:20-21. Trust in the Lord, it strengthens health and life. My son, attend to my words, incline thy ear unto my sayings, for they are life unto those that find them, and health to all earthless. So God requires here for us to listen to him, listen to his principles of health. Okay, let's move on to the next health principle. Okay, balance work and exercise with sleep and rest. This is what I'm saying. It is also important that we need to work, but we need to balance our life. Okay, let's see from here. Balance work and exercise with sleep and rest. 6 days shalt thou labor and do all thy work, but the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord your God. In it thou shalt not do any work. Exodus 20:9-10. So it's clear from here, guys and friends, now you understand more clearly that the Sabbath was given unto man. Okay, we have studied this already about the Sabbath, because God has a purpose in it that we need to have rest. Okay, rest from what? Okay, from our labor. The sleep of a laboring man is sweet. Ecclesiastes 5:12, in the sweat of your face shalt thou eat bread. Okay, it is vain for you to rise up early to sit up late here. Okay, for what hath man of all his labor and of the vexation of his heart, wherein he hath labored under the sun? For all his days are sorrows, and his travail grief ye. Young, his heart taking not rest in the night, this is vanity. This is what Solomon says in his book, Ecclesiastes 2:20-23. All things in this world are vanity. Why vanity? Because things in this world cannot give life, cannot give eternal life. So, okay, let's continue, guys, for the next principle. Keep your body clean. So this is very important, that sanitation must be observed as well. Okay, let's continue in here. Okay, here it says Isaiah 52:11. You can read it from here. So next principle, be temperate in all things, meaning self-control. You should know how to control. And every man that striveth for the mastery is temperate in all things. Now they do it to obtain a corruptible crown, but we an incorruptible. 1 Corinthians 9:25. Let your moderation be known unto all men. The Lord is at hand, according to Philippians 4:5. Okay, more on this. A Christian should completely avoid things that are harmful and be moderate in use of things that are good. Habits that injure health break the command, thou shalt not kill, by degrees. They are suicide on the installment plan. Okay, let's move on here. Okay, next principle is found in 1 Corinthians 3:16-17. Avoid anything harmful to the body. Okay, you have to listen carefully now, guys, because this is clear from here. All right, it says here, this might surprise you, but medical science confirms that tea, coffee, and soft drinks that contain the drug caffeine and other harmful ingredients are damaging to the human body. None of this contains food value except through the sugar or cream added. And most of us already use too much sugar. Stimulants give a damaging artificial boost to the body and are like trying to carry a ton in a wheelbarrow. The popularity of these drinks is due not to flavor or advertising, but to the doses of caffeine and sugar they contain. Many Americans are sickly because of their addiction to coffee, tea, and soft drinks. This delights the devil and damages human lives. Okay, science has labeled coffee a drug, and in recent studies, science has confirmed that only 250 milligrams of coffee can result in a 27% decrease in cerebral blood flow. Okay, here, that is the blood flow to the decision-making part of the brain. The effect is similar to alcohol in causing certain parts of the brain not function at capacity. Oh, all right, you have to continue. But hold on, guys. I have to do some here because I cannot see myself on the screen here. Okay, you suppose, so you have... Okay, no. All right, I have to check on this, guys. Hold on. Okay, it's now okay. Okay, I have to share again my screen here. Okay, here. Okay. Sorry. Okay, let's check from here. Sorry, guys, but we can do this. Okay, because I cannot see my... Okay, here, there we go. Because I cannot see my face on the screen, that's why I... redo. Okay, here, let's continue. The next principle of the Bible about health is make mealtime a happy time. Okay, in here, every man should eat and drink and enjoy the good of all his labor. It is the gift of God. That's why during a mealtime, we should not talk about sad things, about worries, about depression, anything that will not be, contribute good environment during the mealtime. So because during mealtime, we have to enjoy the food. We should have a happy time. Here, it's very clear from here, and that is biblical. Unhappy scenes at mealtime hinder digestion, avoid them. So it's very clear from here. Yeah. Okay, it affects our digestive organ. If we are not happy during our mealtime, then the digestive organ suffers. Okay, so let's avoid of those sad moments during mealtime. Okay, next principle, fasting and help those who are in need. Okay, it is not this fast. Okay, this is all about having fasting, meaning you have to decide how many days in a week you have to go on fasting. I never tried this one, but I guess this is a good experience according to some people who have tried this one, fasting. They have fasted for some, like for instance, once a week during Saturday. They don't eat anything, okay, for the whole day. And they said it gives them comfort. It gives them happiness and fulfillment. It seems that everything is refreshed. Okay, fresh and good to experience, good feelings as well. So here, let's continue the next principle of health in the Bible. Okay, not mingling seed. Okay, what does it mean? Okay, let's read from here. Mingling. Thou shalt not sow thy vineyard with divers seeds, lest fruit of thy seed which thou hast sown and the fruit of thy vineyard be defiled. Okay, maybe I'll jump here. Scientists today have been genetically modifying or crossbreeding seeds with different genes from different plants, and the result of this man-made modification had been horrific. Many countries today have banned GMO, okay, foods after seeing the effects of them. Okay, there are man-made modification of vegetable. Yeah, here, I can see here in some other place here, because they can easily grow. It's very surprising that you have just this plant in a few days, in a few weeks, then you have fruits already. We have this in our balcony. So this might be part of the GMO or the modern man-made modification or cross-breeding of seeds. Okay, we should avoid this one. Okay, let the land rest every 7 years. We only have to look at recent history to find an answer. Okay, it's not. So this one is a long, long story. We have to jump from here and let's move here. Okay, next principle, not mixing wool in linen. So I leave this unto you guys to read for this one. Okay, next question. What solemn reminder is given to those who ignore God's principles? So we are now going to the application. Okay, be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. Okay, Galatians 6 verse 7. Those who ignore God's health principle will more likely reap broken bodies and burn out lives. So just as one who abuses his automobile will likely have serious car trouble, and those who continue to break God's laws of health will ultimately be destroyed. Guys, I want to emphasize more on this. Okay, the health laws of God or the principles of God written in the Bible. If we keep on ignoring of this, then our body will suffer much. Okay, if you are now in hospital bed, okay, if you are now suffering certain diseases, you have to ask yourself, what is my lifestyle? What was my lifestyle? How do prepare my food? What foods that I'm taking? So you should know. If you have a peptic ulcer, then it seems that you are okay, you don't eat at proper time, or you have a peptic ulcer, it's just because you have too much worries. When we think much, or if we have more worries in lives, then our organs keep on grinding, especially the digestive organ, our intestines, and here in part in our stomach or inside our stomach, here, there, that's why it suffers. Okay, so better yet, we have to know, we have to understand, and we should listen to the Bible principles about health. Okay, let's continue, guys. What shocking truth about health involves our children and grandchildren? Okay, it's very clear from here. If we ignore the health principles of the Bible, who will be affected? In other words, okay, thou shalt not eat it, that it may go well with thee and with thy children after thee. Deuteronomy 12:25. Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them that serve him, for the Lord thy God, I'm jealous God. Okay, let's go down. Many people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, because thou hast rejected knowledge. I will also reject thee, that thou shalt be no priest to me. Seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy God, I will also forget thy children. Sickness in our children nowadays, sickness in our babies, yeah. Why is it happening? Is it the will of God? No, it is the way we live. It is the way we prepare our food, or it is the way we choose our foods. Okay, here, God makes it plain that children and grandchildren to the fourth generation pay for the folly of parents who ignore God's health principles. The children and grandchildren inherit weakened, sickly bodies when their mothers and fathers defy God's rules for their lives. Wouldn't you avoid anything else that might harm your precious children and grandchildren? I'll give you an example, guys. If you are a pregnant woman, then you keep on smoking. You keep on smoking because your habit is smoking. So what happens to the fetus, the growing baby inside your tummy? Yeah, it affects. Sometimes there are deformities in babies, like when they were born. So this is your fault. Sorry for that word. But this is your lapses, because you didn't observe the principle of health. Yeah, you keep on smoking, you keep on drinking wine while you are pregnant. So what can you expect? Some deformities, of the part of your kid or your baby. Okay. And it's not good because the baby is innocent, then the baby suffers for the rest of her or his life because of the lapses of a mother or a mother. Okay, what other sovereign fact does God's word reveal? Okay, let's read from Revelation 21, verse 27. There shall be no means enter into it God's kingdom glory. Anything that defiles, meaning defiles you rejected or you contaminated. Okay, here, but as for them whose heart walketh after the heart of their detestable things and their abominations, I will recompense their way upon their own heads, saith the Lord God. Nothing defiling or unclean will be permitted in God's kingdom. Yesterday, I mentioned this, that no one can enter the kingdom of God if he is not following the will of God or the law of God. Here, like, because you're abusing your body. Remember, our body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. When there is a temple, the temple is a dwelling place of God or the Holy Spirit. So better yet, we have to take good care of our body. If filthy habits defile a person, use of improper food defiles a person, according to Daniel 1:8. Remember what happened to Daniel and his friends? They were offered the food and the wine of the king, but they rejected because they knew that those things, those foods are not good for their bodies. And you found out, guys, they become more handsome, they become more healthier compared to those people who ate the food and drink the wine of the kings. Okay, this is the best example I guess I can give to you. It is sovereign but true, choosing their own ways, and those things in which God does not delight will end up costing people their eternal salvation. Okay, let's continue, and we're about to end our Bible study this afternoon. Okay, let's move on. What should every sincere Christian endeavor to do at once? I'd be blind to understanding some of these principles. This is a good one because at least at this point in time, you realize the importance of the Bible principles about health or health principles. Okay, let's read from 2 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 1. Let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and spirit, and every man that he had this hope in him purified himself even as he is pure. If you love me, keep my commandments. John 14:15. Sincere Christians will bring their lives into harmony with God's health principles immediately because they love him. Why you follow the health principle? Because you love God. God is the one who created your body. God is the one who gives us life. So therefore, we have to take good care of his temple, which is our body. They know that his rules only add to their happiness and protect them from the devil's diseases, according to Acts 10:38. God's counsel and rules are always for our good. Just as good parents, rules and counsel are best for their children. And once we know better, God holds us accountable. Therefore, to him that knoweth to do good and doeth it not, to him it is sin. If you know the principle, if you are now aware of the principle of the Bible, so therefore the lesson is there already. You are now aware, you are forewarned, and you are. I have given to you the principles. I bring to you, okay, should I say. So you are now aware of this principle. If you keep on rejecting, ignoring these principles of the Bible, health principles of the Bible, then you will suffer. You will reap of what you sow, right? Here, let's continue, guys. Some evil habits bind people so tightly. What can they do? Okay. But as many as receive him, to them give power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe in his name. I can do all things through Christ who strengthened me. Okay. In here. Okay. Let's continue, guys. So the answer for this one, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. So no, don't worry if you are in addiction of caffeine, diba? If you are in addiction in tea, coffee, and soft drinks, and unclean foods, then you can go to God directly, ask God his guidance, his his provision, his providence, his intervention for you to stop doing such things. Okay, let's continue, guys. What thrilling promises are given about God's new kingdom? Okay, the inhabitants shall not say, I am sick. Isaiah 33 verse 24, there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying. There shall be no more pain, Revelation 21 verse 4. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with their wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. Okay, the citizens of God's new kingdom will gladly follow his health principles, and there will be no sickness or disease in heaven. They will be blessed with eternal vigor and youth, and will live with God in supreme joy and happiness throughout all eternity. All right, before I leave, okay, before I end this Bible study about God's health plan, okay, since healthful living truly is part of Bible religion, are you willing to follow all of God's health principles? Okay, I leave these questions to you guys. It's up to you. I cannot say anything more than on these words and these questions, but this can be answered by yourself. Okay, let's. I'm going to end now our PowerPoint so that I can go back to the big screen. Okay, there you go. All right, guys. Thank you for watching this Bible study this afternoon, and it's all about God's health plan. Okay, God's health plan. Okay, he has a plan for us, and it's all about health. So that is the reason why there are a lot of videos you can see from here, from my background picture, my virtual background pictures, because I wanted you to be reminded what are the important things or food that we should take. It's just because God is after of our health. God is not happy if we are sick, if we have illnesses like right now. Okay, the coronavirus, okay, you might say that it's not our fault, but it's the fault of the originator, because they don't practice hygiene and everything, like what I said yesterday, that they eat anything around, okay, anything that they can see. They eat. Okay, that's why. Okay, so we cannot negate the fact that this is because Satan is wanting us to be sick as well. Okay, because if you are sick, you cannot glorify God. If you are not sick, you cannot go to church. If you are sick, you cannot share the gospel of God. So what is the principle this afternoon? Okay, I have given all the 14 principles that you can find, okay, in the Bible, and it's very clear, very, very clear in there. So my message this afternoon, guys, before I end this Bible study, is that we have to take good care of our body for a single reason. Could be because our body is a temple of God. Another thing, God is the creator of our body. He knows what is best for us. He knows what type of food should we take. Should we intake? Why? Because he knows the capacity of our body, and anything that we put on or inside our mouth, okay, anything that we eat will affect the totality of our being. Okay, it affects our social aspect, because if you eat more on meat, then you become irritable person. You become ill-tempered. You can easily provoke, or you can see easily get angry, right? So another thing, if you eat unclean foods, then sanitation is no longer there. Then you got sick, or you get sick, or you will suffer several multiple diseases in your body. See, it's just because we are not careful enough of the food that we eat. So this is the goal of our Bible study this afternoon, that we should be reminded that God has created good fruit-bearing trees. Yeah, like what you can see right now, you can eat fruits. Instead of drinking wine, you can make juice or you can make anything from the fresh fruit itself. So by taking wine, it clouds your mind. It makes you dumb. It makes you crazy sometimes. You cannot control yourself. Okay, instead of eating meat, yeah, protein can be found in meat, but there are also several vegetables that you can find protein. It's just you have to double the portion of the vegetable that you have to eat. Okay, because the meat is different as well. It's more heavier. It's more you will gain more protein from it. But vegetable as well can provide us. So here in Switzerland, I changed my diet, guys. It's not important if you are thin, as long as you are healthy. It's not good that you are obese and you look like in good health because you have a bulk body, you have muscle and everything. But deep inside, there is a, should I say, sepulcher? Should I say there is something wrong with your body? Your blood pressure is not okay, always high. Okay, in contrast, your BP is low. So you can be anemic or what should I say? Okay, low blood. Or if you eat more fat, then you are obese. Then you are prone to heart attacks. So, guys, are you willing to sacrifice your body because of your taste? Taste is not a safe guide when it comes to good health. It's not only nutrition. We need also to exercise. We need also to have fresh air. We need also to have rest. Okay, that's why there is Sabbath. There is rest in a week. Okay, God has given us this 7th day of the week for us to rest from all our labors. Then if you are working throughout the week and you have no time to rest, you will suffer of what you have done. Okay. So everything is made from us. The reason that we got sick is just because of us as well. Okay, lack of sleep then. Yeah, it's not good as well. Lack of exercise is not good as well. Lack of nutrition is not good as well. And you're having no good, you're not in good terms with your neighbor or friends, your husband and wife. It's not good as well. So water is important as well. We have to drink water. 70% of body weight is water. So there are things that we have to consider. Okay, there are things that we need to remember. And those things are all provided by God for us to exist with a happy, happy, happy life. Okay. All right. Thank you for watching. And for those of you who will be watching later, okay, for the watch party, and thank you for that, and thank you for those people who keep on sharing my videos. And one favor, again, guys, please continue liking and what should I say, following, sharing my ministry page, which is Friends on Air Europe. Again, Friends on Air Europe is my ministry page. Please like, follow, and share my videos, because nowadays we need to inform other people. Another thing, we need to remind other people about good health. Our health is our biggest capital in our life. It's not our degree. It's not our PhD. It's not our master's. It's not our good work. It's not our anything that you have right now in your life. It's not the material things, but it is our body. It's our health, it's our capital. Because if we transgress the law of health, then our body will deteriorate and therefore we cannot achieve anything anymore. How can you work if you are sick? If you are a sickly person. So you have to better take good care of this body that God has provided to us. And this is the temple of the Holy Spirit. All right. My name is Fritz, and this is Friends on Air Europe. And I would like to say in German, the way I would like to say goodbye, auf Wiedersehen, tschüss, and also in Italian, that is ciao. And in English, bye-bye, goodbye. I pray. I hope and pray that you learn something from these two series of our study about God's health plan for us. All right. Bye-bye. Bis Morgan, meaning see you tomorrow. Bye for now.